This week, two of the biggest YouTubers on the platform opened up and discussed how their success didn't make them happy. But in this video, we're gonna discuss what the solution to that is, so make sure you stay tuned. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And the two YouTubers that I'm speaking about today are h3h3 Productions, as well as the biggest YouTuber on the platform, Mr. PewDiePie himself. Both of them just made videos this week about how they thought success would lead them to happiness. And this is a completely flawed point of view. And the problem is that nobody believes it until it happens to them. So I'm hoping that with this video, I can teach you why this is not true and why we need to change the way we perceive these things. This is something that we're taught from a very young age. We're taught that success equals happiness, and it's absolutely not true. It's something that I bring up a lot in my addiction videos. When I talk about Carrie Fisher, I had a video on her not that long ago. I talk about other celebrities who commit suicide or struggle with depression. It's because of this flawed idea that success equals happiness. So most of you watching this video are from a million different walks of life, and you're on that grind, going to work and all these other things, and you think that it's going to bring you happiness once you get to this point. We think that the next raise we get, the next promotion we get, the next car we buy, the next relationship we get in, when we can lose a few pounds, when we can look a certain way, all these different things, we think those things are going to bring us happiness, this false idea of success. The problem is that every time we reach that point, we move the goalpost. So anytime that we get to that point, now something new needs to make us happy. So we're constantly in this sick and twisted cycle of looking for something new. And what happens is, not only does it destroy our mental health, but it leads to a lot of toxic behaviors, right? Nothing's ever good enough, you know? So something that's a great analogy is back in the 1500s, people thought that the earth was the center of the universe. Okay, they thought that the earth stood still and the sun revolved around it, okay? And it wasn't until Copernicus came around, he's like, yo, I'm starting to think this might not be the case. I'm starting to think that maybe the earth actually revolves around the sun, right? And people thought that that was crazy. So think about it, for thousands of years, people thought that the sun revolved around the earth. This is the same kind of relationship that we have to change when it comes to success and happiness. We think that success is in the middle and happiness revolves around it. But through thousands and thousands of different studies, we've discovered that success actually revolves around happiness. A lot of that information is in a book that I'm gonna link in the description below. It's called The Happiness Advantage, from a guy named Sean Anker, who is a professor of positive psychology at Harvard. But anyways, without further ado, let's take a look first at this clip from PewDiePie talking about this.
I think a lot of people have this illusion in their head that money and fame is gonna bring them some sort of happiness. And I think a lot of YouTubers and a lot of entertainers, when they get this, get to the point where actually I have everything I want or thought I wanted, but I don't feel happy and I don't feel fulfilled. And that just makes them even more unhappy and less fulfilled. And it can be a very negative thing.
All right, you heard it from PewDiePie himself. He discussed this. He, back in the day, I stumbled across a motivational video somebody put together of PewDiePie in the early days, and he was just so grateful for the fans and everything like that. But then he got to this point where he became the biggest YouTuber on the platform, and the video clip that you just watched, it came from a follow-up video he did from a year ago talking about how people have this forced positivity. And one of the ways he got out of his funk was realizing that he doesn't have to fake happiness, and now he's doing things that actually make him happy, and he is happy, okay? But the other case that this came from was Ethan Klein, or you might know him from h3h3 Productions, all right? So let's take a look at this clip.
And one of the worst parts about it was that I was depressed, but I had everything that I had ever wanted. I had absolutely no reason objectively on paper to ever be depressed, and yet I was. And so that made me even more frustrated.
So Ethan right there, this is something that perfectly describes what fuels our depressive moods, okay? Because we've been taught from a young age that success equals happiness, then we get to that point and we're depressed, then we start judging our depression, right? Not only that, but the rest of the world starts judging our depression. You know what I mean? I just did a video the other day on Nicole Arbour's silly self talking about, she was talking about how you shouldn't be depressed.
Look at our lives. We have amazing technology. Grocery stores full of food and seats that heat up your butt in the winter.
Hey.
Or if you're a genius like me, you turn on the heat seat and keep your fast food warm.
Ah.
And yet we are the most depressed that humans have ever been in the history of the world.
We have all this amazing stuff. You shouldn't be depressed. And that's part of the problem, is that we think things equal happiness. And I hope what you're gathering from this video is that that whole idea is completely flawed, okay? So when it comes to this thing, we need to start looking at how our happiness can actually fuel our success. So what I want you to look at, or I want you to think about some of the happiest people you know and what they actually have in their life. One of the things that I learned from this book, The Happiness Advantage, is that there's so many different studies that show how happiness fuels motivation and creativity and all these things. So what you really start to see is that your happiness, if you work on that first, success will follow soon behind, all right? But just to sell you a little bit more on this book, here's a quick clip from it.
More than a decade of groundbreaking research in the fields of positive psychology and neuroscience has proven, in no uncertain terms, that the relationship between success and happiness works the other way around. Thanks to this cutting-edge science, we now know that happiness is the precursor to success, not merely the result.
All right, everybody. So just remember, chasing the success isn't necessarily going to bring you happiness. All it's going to do is make you chase more of this false sense of happiness, okay? So what you need to start working on now is your own sense of happiness, and I will be doing more videos about this. But what I want from all of you, if you're still with me, go ahead and leave a comment below. I would love for you to prove me wrong. I would love for you to tell me how you hit this point in your life once you graduated college, or once you got that promotion or that raise, or once you hit a certain dollar amount at work, you were just no longer ever sad in your life, okay? Because I might be wrong, but what I'm guessing is some of you are gonna leave comments down below where you can actually relate to this, and you already are kind of seeing that you're constantly chasing, constantly seeking, constantly moving your own goalposts for happiness, okay? So be sure to leave a comment down below, all right? But if you like this video, if you want me to make more videos about happiness and touch on some other things in this book by Sean Anker, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you wanna check the book out, make sure you go to that link in the description below. It's an affiliate link. So what that means, no extra cost to you. It helps support the channel. I can make more beautiful videos like this one, all right? So anyways, thanks so much for watching. And if you're new here, I'm always making videos to help you out with your mental health. Go ahead and click that little round subscribe button. If you wanna check out some of the other videos on this channel, I have over 200 of them, but click or tap on one of the thumbnails right there. All right, so stay happy, y'all, and I'll see you next time.